Welcome to our lecture online. Now here we have a problem where we have a brass shaft that has a diameter slightly over 3 centimeters, 3.002 centimeters, and a steel ring which needs to be placed over the shaft, but the inner diameter is only 3.000 centimeters. Notice that the linear coefficient of expansion for steel is 1.2 times 10 to the minus 5 per centigrade degree. For brass, it's 2.0 times 10 to the minus 5 per centigrade degree. Let's say that we start out with both pieces at 20 degrees centigrade. So what we want to do is we want to heat up the steel ring so that it will fit over the shaft. Now the question is, at what temperature will the steel ring fit over the brass shaft and only heat the ring? So we have to do this quickly, because if we start placing the ring over the shaft and the temperature or the heat from the ring goes into the shaft will begin to expand and we want to be able to fit it over. So we want to do it quickly as soon as the ring is large enough. Now it turns out that when you heat the ring will indeed get larger, but the inner diameter will stretch just as the outer diameter will stretch based upon the increase in temperature, as if it was a steel piece that was in there. So for example, if I had like a steel ruler that had a length exactly equal to the diameter, the inside diameter of the ring, and I were to heat both the ring and the steel shaft or the steel tape, then they would expand the same amount. So the inner radius will expand outward with an increase in temperature, just like a steel ruler would of that exact same length. So what we can do then is try to figure out how much heat I would require, or what a temperature would be required in order to get the inner diameter to be 3.002 centimeters. In other words, we want the change in the diameter to be equal to 0.002 centimeters. That's what we would need to get over the shaft, which would be equal to the original diameter times the linear coefficient of expansion times the change in the temperature. And since we're looking for the change in the temperature, the change in the temp would be equal to the change in the diameter divided by the coefficient times the original. So we take the change divided by the coefficient divided by the original diameter, and that should give us the change in the temperature. So that means we want 0.002 centimeters divided by the coefficient, and this would be the coefficient of steel. That would be 1.2 times 10 to the minus 5 per centigrade degree. This would be centimeters, and then the original diameter would be equal to 3.000, and of course also centimeters, so the centimeters would cancel and we end up with centigrade degrees. Okay, 0.002 divided by 3 divided by 1.2 e to the 5 minus equals, and it looks like we need about 55.6 degrees, so that's equal to 55.6 centigrade degrees. Notice that's not degree centigrade, that's centigrade degrees, which is a delta temperature, a difference in temperature, which means that T final would be equal to T initial plus the change in the temperature. So the T initial would be 20 degrees centigrade plus an additional, let's round it to 56 centigrade degrees. When we add this to this, that is equal to 76 degrees centigrade for the final temperature. So all we have to do is heat the ring up to 76 degrees centigrade and the ring will fit over the brass shaft. In the next video, we're going to need to figure out what temperature will be required in order to remove the ring. So stay tuned and take a look at that video.